Friday, 17 September 2021 was a spirit-filled day to His Excellency Governor Dom Emmanuel, the Christian faithful, Jerusalem pilgrims, and all who attended the one-day solemn assembly organized by Akwaibom State Christian Pilgrims Welfare Board at United Evangelical Church, Ikoroku, Beaufort.
Situation in the nation where man has taken over the nation, kidnappings, the economy is not stable, everything is in chaos, and they believe that pilgrims and Christians can come together and cry out unto the Lord, and the Lord will hear us.
Declaring the event opened, the chairman of the Pilgrim Board, Archbishop Cletus Bercy, in his welcome remarks, appreciated the governor for Akwaibom State, His Excellency Deacon Udom Emmanuel, for approving the event, while calling on continued support of the Akwaibom Christian Pilgrims Welfare Board.
Jeffy, praise the Lord!
Hallelujah.
It is with a deep sense of appreciation and excitement that I warmly welcome His Excellency, the Executive Governor of Akwaibom State, Deacon Udom Emmanuel, the Deputy Governor, the Secretary to the State Government, even though he is here to represent the Executive Governor of Akwaibom State, members of the board, the priests of God, ministers of the gospel, Jerusalem pilgrims, Christian faithfuls, invited guests, ladies and gentlemen of the praise, and please let me pause to acknowledge the SSL religious matter that is here with us today. I welcome you to this wonderful assembly with the theme, Mighty Things Through Praise.
He said that it has been the custom of the board to prayerfully organize a solemn assembly to appreciate God for His magnanimity and benevolence while seeking His divine intervention.
Let me specifically appreciate His Excellency, our ever hard working governor, for graciously approving this event, as he himself is a man who believes in prayer. He believes in divine direction and in constant testable power of the supernatural over the natural. Your Excellency, we thank you and we celebrate you for your dynamism in serving God's purpose in our dear spirit. On behalf of the board, we also like to seize these auspicious moment to appeal to our dearly beloved Admiral Governor and his administration for their continuous support to the Akwaibom Christian Pilgrims Welfare as the true value of a society is seen in the quality of its.
The Archbishop said the theme for the solemn assembly tagged Mighty Things Through Prayers is from the book of Jeremiah 33 verse 3, which emphasizes a call to God for a solution to all problems.
It has been the custom of the board to prayerfully organize a solemn assembly to appreciate God for His magnanimity, benevolence to us as a people and state, while all also seeking God's divine interventions in our affairs. The theme of this solemn assembly is called from Jeremiah chapter 33, verse number 3, which says, "Come unto me, and I will answer thee, and show thee great and mighty things which thou knowest not." I believe that no point in our very nation and our dear state do we need to call on God more than ever right now. The worrisome state of insecurity, kidnapping of students, countless attacks on our security architecture are a few reasons we must approach God in repentance and seek His mighty works through the unfailing power of prayer. I therefore enjoin us as we pray together today, let our faith be unshaken, for if there is a man to pray, there is a God to answer.
First prayer session was on Thanksgiving, led by Archbishop Chris Ekong of the Lutheran Church in Nigeria.
Today we have gathered as God's people to thank God for the many things He has done for us. According to 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 18. But because the theme of this solemn assembly is from Jeremiah, let me also read to you Jeremiah chapter 30, verse 19, and it reads, "From them will come songs of thanksgiving and the sound of rejoicing. I will add to their numbers, and they will not be decreased. I will bring them honor, and they will not be disdained." Thank you for this evening after you. Thank you for this leadership that acknowledges you. Thank you for a people who even when we fell and fall, today we thank and praise you. Thank you, Lord, for you truly are our God. Amen.
Governor Domi Emmanuel, who was represented at the event by the Secretary to the State Government, Mr. Emmanuel Okwuem, took the Bible reading on Psalm 65, verse 1 and 2.
The Bible reading is from Psalm 65, in James version. Praise waiting for thee, O God, in Zion. Not to thee shall the vow be upon. O thou that hearest prayer, unto thee shall all flesh come. Iniquities prevail against thee. As for our transgressions, thou shalt punish them away. So, my brothers and sisters, this is the word of the Lord.
In his address, he called on prayers from the church for the choice of God concerning the governor of Akwa Ibom State in 2023.
But I would like us to remember the thing that the governor does say, and he has said to fact of him, that whoever succeeds him will not be his choice, that will be the choice of God. It's a very profound statement, really profound. Really profound. The Bible says that for those of us who believe in God and who are children of the Lord Jesus, that whatever we set our hands upon, we should do what? We shall prosper, isn't it? Look at me. God doesn't pick the qualified. God picks whether he picks the qualifies. So you don't get ready. God does not choose the qualified. It is those that he God chooses that he God qualifies. So it's about prayer. That's what it's about, prayer. Believe in God. Father in heaven, guide the Lord. Protect him. Inspire him. Strengthen him. Give him divine information. And since he sits at the top of the court, when you come on, the public will manifest. Let him be the good of our head, Jesus, then we pray.
Then came the word of X by the founder of Wilderness Voice Ministries, Apostle Chris Nyong.
We come here to join our faith together. We pray to have this mighty things in our Bible state. If you understand, pray, shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And so, by the grace of God, where His Excellency read, which is the book of Psalms, number 65, the Bible says, praise waiteth for thee, O God, in Zion. And unto thee shall the vow be performed. And in verse 2, O thou that hearest prayer, unto thee shall all flesh come. There is a God with the power, with the responsibility to hear and to answer prayers. And here the Bible says that unto him shall all flesh come. That's why we are here. In order to attain and to achieve mighty things, there is a typical example that we want to take present today as we embark on this prayer convocation properly.
The second prayer session for the church and God's forgiveness to leaders who mislead the people was led by Reverend Akwatang.
Let the will of God, let the hand of the Lord come into our state, come be into our land and dictate all our pains and movement, so that everything will be according to His will. God will remember is a gift to our parents, it is a gift to Nigeria. God, indeed, we can testify that this one is a gift. Begin to thank God for that. Lord, give us a leader. Lord, give us a shepherd. Lord, give us a leader. Lord, give us a shepherd. Lead our Bible state to the path of righteousness. In the path of righteousness, lead our Bible state to excellence, to success, to triumph. Enlarge our coast. Bless our land.
The third prayer session for the youths and those in the academic sector was taken by Reverend Mrs. Sylvia Imo.
We want to stretch our hands. As we stretch this hand, they are over the heads of our children all over the states. We may not see them physically, but just imagine that hand as a father and mother is resting on the children of our father's single state. We want to pray that and say, oh Lord God, give us children in whose life is excellent spirit. Let our children have knowledge, understanding, showing hard sentences, dissolving doubts, and let them find favor wherever they are in any part of this world. May our Bible children stand out wherever they go. May they be like Daniel, Shadrach, and Abednego, while in this state and outside this state. May they be inventors and not destroyers.
Pastor Silvanus Okafia of the Inside Bible Church took up the fifth prayer session for Ukwaibom State government and political class.
Let's ask God to bless our government. Call his name and say to God what you want to see in his land. What you want his government to do. Let's pray for the completion agenda. Let's pray for the political class here, represented by the SSG, SUC, as a point of contact, that everyone on whose hands they lean, honestly, they will be genuine, they will love. They won't get advice that will only benefit the advisor. For everyone who is part of the government, honesty will be their word for. Have the sincerity of hope. The grace of God will be manifested upon them. Thank you. In the name of Jesus.
The sixth prayer session for the 2021 pilgrimage was taken by Reverend Udeme Akpan.
The Lord has some prayers. In the name of Jesus Christ. For the prayers here for pilgrims, both here in Nigeria and outside this country, as we go into the promised land, as we pray.
Let it be felt here in our Bible, let it be felt in Nigeria, let it be felt in Asia, let it be felt in Afghanistan, let it be felt in North America, let it be felt in India, let it be felt all over the world. Impact, impact, impact. Let people say, wow, there's something unique about this people called Christmas.
High points of the event witness. Presentation by
may you receive this in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Thank you, sir.
Choir ministration by United Evangelical Church Choir, Believers Assembly Church Choir, St. Bridget Catholic Parish Choir, Praise and Worship, Vote of Thanks by the Board Secretary, and benediction closing by Reverend also a Drogban.
We are going to come together and pray. And today we are praying because the Bible tells us Prophet Solomon was dedicating the temple. In Chapter 7, Chronicles 6, 32 to 33, he said, if a stranger comes from a far country to this land, talking about Israel, and he prays unto you, God answer God so that they'll know that there's a God in Israel. You see that in 2 Chronicles 6, 32, 33. And because we prayed in Israel and God answered, she fervently believed that if we come to Abraham and pray, having been to the land where God dwelt, that God will make Abraham an extension of Israel. And so is it going to be in Jesus' name. We think we are gathered here. One of the things they told us is that this is the first time government is coming to their church. And we pray because they opened their church to us. When Obede don't open his doors.
Thank you.
radio television show, an NTA crew had a one-on-one interview with the following personalities.
Today is a special day for us. Why is it special? We came together, we decided to see the face of God concerning our nation, concerning our state and our people. And now we are told, when there's a people to pray, there's a God to answer. So I'm excited because I know God has heard us and God has answered us. And we know whatever we have prayed here, because it is His word that if we pray, answer. He has answered and things will turn around for us in Jesus' name.
Understand that every time prayer is being offered, the resulting effect will be evidenced by the different activities and the happenings that will take place. I strongly believe that after today's prayer, God is going to give the governor direction, even as we have spoken and we have prayed. We also are praying for our children, our young people. We are believing that God will help them to, you know, have direction and then have the fear of God. We also believe that there will be unity in the church. And we also have asked God, wherever we have done as a church, that have brought misdirection, misleading, that God will begin to overturn all of that and help us to see an amazing church that is strong, that is one voice as one body. So we
should come back to home with the Spirit also to affect and transform a fellow person or Christian that perhaps has never been there. In fact, going to Israel and coming back carries what I would like to describe as spiritual, contagious transformation. Spiritual, contagious transformation.
I want to appreciate the excellency, the person of Governor Udom Emmanuel. I've been hearing of him in the first tenure when I was in River State, and now I come to enjoy the privileges and the blessing God has endowed upon him to help the state. But I also ask God to keep him and all his board, and even the pilgrim members, board members, the chairman, the clergy's pastor. I pray that the Lord will help them to maintain their integrity. I thank all their Bible. God will continue to uphold us in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you. I felt the presence of the Most High God here, and I just want to thank God because our prayers have been answered. God has brought peace to the state, Akwa Abasi of state, and God has blessed His Excellency, Governor Udom Emmanuel. I, as one of the clergy, my name is Reverend Dr. Ambassador Boswe Monday JP, want to return thanks to God for a successful service like this. I have never seen a service like this. It's awesome. May the name of the Lord be praised forever and ever and ever in Jesus' name.
Thank God that the managers of Akwa-Ibom State Christian Pilgrim Board have given their consent that this event be held here. We thank the state governor who also graced the event, though represented by the secretary to the state governor. It's a good development for the church, and we thank God for this development. Even as we all, as Christians, we owe the government, the land, the duty of praying for the good of the land. So they should not relent in praying for the state, the peace of the state, the peace of Nigeria, and every hamlet. So they should not relent, and even we as Christians, we should not relent in doing that as well.
This is Engineer from the Mondogodo, the chief consultant. I'm happy to let you know, 4 years ago I was broke as a graduate looking for what to do. I never had a good source of income. And a friend showed me this business. I had to open up my mind to say yes to this opportunity. Today we build people who are making money, excess money. We are buying cars, building houses, developing ourselves because of daily income. So you want to make daily income, you have to be part of the business. If you are living today, you are spending money every day, you need to make money every day. If you are not making money every day, you are missing out on this opportunity. For the fact that you spend money every day, you deserve to make money every day. I want to see you be part of this business today. Get in touch with the person that's seen the video and be part of the business today and say yes to this opportunity. Thank you so much.